which nobody can deny.
It's no good, Spider. You can't escape that easily. We're coming in after you. This way, David. We'd best separate. I'm getting down there. You check the white vigil. Any sign of him, Davis?
Well, no, nothing here.
All right, we'll check the spleen. Wait! Oh my God, he's double back on us. Quick, we've got to catch him before he reaches the neck.
Icelandic saga, written by an unknown hand in the late 13th century, has remained undiscovered until today. Now it comes to your screens for the first time, fresh from the leaves of Iceland's history, the terrible Njol's saga.
It's not that terrible.
No, I meant terribly violent.
Oh, yeah.
Erik Njol, son of Hrothgar, leaves his home to seek Hangnor the Elder at the house of Thorvald Hrodvizir. The son of Goodleaf, half-brother of Thorgeir, the priest of the Osawater, who took to wife Thorun, the mother of Thorkel Braggart, the slayer of Goodman the Powerful, who knew Harald, son of Geirnund, son of Erik from Gdalis, son of Arvard Bristlebeard, son of Harkon, who killed Gjortgard in Soknedale in Norway, over Gudrid, daughter of Thorkel Long, the son of Kettle Trout, the half-son of Harbjorn Halfchol, brother of Ingvard the Brave, who wed Isenbert of Gottenberg, the daughter of Hangbard the Fierce, of the...
We apologize for an error in the saga. Evidently, Thorgeir, the priest of Ljosawater, who took to wife Thorin, the mother of Thorkel Braggart, the slayer of Goodman the Powerful, who knew Harald, son of Geirmund, son of Erik from Gdalis.
Well, I'm afraid we're having a little trouble getting this very exciting Icelandic saga started. If any of you at home have any ideas about how to get this exciting saga started again, here's the address to write to.
Help the exciting Icelandic saga, 18B, McNaughton Buildings, Oban.
Hello. Well, I was the third voice you heard just now. I'm sorry about that terrible mess.
Wasn't all that terrible?
No, I meant terrible in the sense of unfortunate.
Oh.
Anyway, our plea for assistance has been answered by the North Morden Icelandic Saga Society, who've given us some very useful information about the saga. And so we carry on now with Njol's saga, with our thanks going once again to the North Morden Icelandic Saga Society.
Erik Njol, son of Hrothgar, rode off into the desolate plain. Day and night he rode, looking neither to right nor left, stopping neither for food nor rest. 12 days and nights he rode, through rain and storm, through wind and snow, beyond the enchanted waterfall, through the elfin glades, until he reached his goal. He had found the rich and pleasant land beyond the mountains. The land where golden streams sang their way through fresh green meadows, where there were halls and palaces, an excellent swimming pool, and one of the most attractive bonus incentive schemes for industrial development in the city. Only 15 miles from excellent Thameside docking facilities, and within easy reach of the proposed M25. Here it was that Eric and Joel, son of Hrothgar, met the mayor, Mr. Arthur Hardynut, a local solicitor.
Welcome to North Malden. Yes, everyone is welcome to North Malden, but none more so than the businessmen and investors who shape our society of the future. Here at North
Malden... And we apologise to viewers of Joel's saga, who may be confused by some of the references to North Malden. After a frank exchange of views, we have agreed to carry on showing this version supplied to us by the North Malden Icelandic Saga Society on the undertaking that future scenes will adhere more closely to the spirit of 12th century Iceland.
With moist eyes, Eric leaves this happy land to return to the harsh and economic realities of life in the land of Leosa Water. On his way, Eric rested a while in the land of Bjornstrand, the land of dark forces, where Gildor was king. These were the dukes of the land of Bjornstrand, proud warriors who bore on their chests the letters of their dread name.
Icelandic Society?
Yes, that's right.
It's about this saga.
Oh, yes, the Icelandic saga.
Yes.
Good, isn't it?
Well, I don't know, but I mean, you promised us that you would stick to the spirit of the original text.
Yes, that's right.
Well, I mean, a lot of these things that are happening, I mean, they just don't quite ring true.
Well, it's a new interpretation, really.
Well, we didn't want a new, we wanted the proper thing. I mean, just look what's happening now.
Banners were a very important part of Icelandic law, Mr. Mill.
Well, no, I'm sorry. I just can't accept that. It's gone too far. I'm very sorry, but we'll have to terminate the agreement.
Oh.
Well, you're just trying to cash in on the BBC's exciting Icelandic saga.
That's business, Mr. Mill.
Well, that's as may be, but it's not the way the BBC works.
What?